The National Chairperson, Comrade Kebby Maphatsoe, will read out the statement for us. Then following that, we will move with procession to questions and all of that.
Our task is to defend our hard-won democracy and the freedom of our people. It is for this reason that we call on all South Africans to be active participants in shaping their own destiny. We call our people to support the efforts of our democratic government to construct a non-racial, non-sexist, democratic and prosperous South Africa. This is the task we should all strive to achieve during our lifetime. This is the task our forebears set themselves and are the task many of the unsung heroes and heroines of our struggle fought and died for. Umkhonto weSizwe Military Veterans Association salutes the gallant fighting spirit of our hero Solomon Kalushu Mahlangu, who was hanged by the apartheid regime almost 35 years ago. MKMVA, in memory of Solomon Mahlangu, who died a member of Umkhonto weSizwe and the African National Congress, would like to introduce a program of activities to honor him on the 35th commemoration of the ultimate sacrifice he paid for actively struggling against the apartheid regime. This program is aimed at informing the society about the memorialization and proper recording of our history of struggle against a barrage of distortions freely disseminated by many in attempts to rewrite our history. We owe it upon the heroes and heroines of our struggle to create awareness around the journey we undertook, a journey that brought about democracy that was not easy and often called for our readiness to sacrifice our own lives. Today, as MKMVA, we stand as humble servants of the people, ready to pass on to the youth this legacy as it was given to us. We undertake this task conscious of the efforts of others who consistently do not only try to distort our history, but couple that with their set efforts to demoralize the society regarding the progress the ANC is making in our difficult program of socio-economic transformation. We as MKMVA, in the memory of our heroes and heroines, are ready to vote for the ANC in the forthcoming elections to be held on the 7th May 2014. In the name of Solomon Kalushu Mahlangu and other heroes and heroines of our struggle, we urge the people of South Africa, especially the youth, to return the ANC to govern with an overwhelming majority. The programs to memorialize Solomon Kalushu Mahlangu on the 35th year of his hanging by the apartheid regime is as follows. Starting from next week, we will be having memorial lectures across the institutions of higher education, and those will be addressed by political commissars of Umkhonto weSizwe. We will be having a gala dinner on Saturday, the 5th of April 2014 at Tshwane City Hall. Possibly the president will be present in the gala dinner. And on Sunday, the 6th of April 2014, there will be a joint program with the ANC, mainly in Gauteng, will be held and communication will follow in this regard. Umkhonto weSizwe Military Veterans Association and indeed the entire liberation movement have in the recent past been observing with dismay the actions and public statements by some of the senior members of our movement, such as Comrade Ronnie Castrels and Marion Spark. Both are considered in the ANC circles as the most tried and tested leaders of our revolution, and to us as the members of Umkhonto weSizwe, the glorious movement of our people. They are considered to be our valiant cadres and strategists. They have earned themselves the household names in recognition to their abilities to avoid the enemy and provide guidance to the military underground during the most difficult times of our struggle. It is therefore correct that we express our dismay and indeed our disappointment at the behavior of this refined cadres of our people, and we see them deteriorating gradually into a force for reaction and counter-revolution. None of us has given up on them. The invitation for them to return and be part of the collective leadership of our movement remains open. We find it hard of ways to express our shock, hence the initial paralysis and inability to respond as this dissipation of the revolutionary fervor from Comrade Ronnie Castrals and Maroon Spark was never expected nor anticipated. We, however, cannot remain mum, as we have a duty to defend the revolution and the advance of our people towards their own liberation. We will take our defensive post irrespective of who the enemy is or is appears to be, in what shape, color, or form the counter-revolution manifests itself. This we consider a historical duty bestowed on us by time and space, hence our response to Comrade Castrals and Maroon Spark as we are here today. Comrade Castrals to declare with his close associates that they can't just vote for this leadership of the ANC, and that if there is nobody else to vote for, then maybe one just spoils the ballot, smacks of double standards, and speaking in forked tongues. For Maroon Spark to stand on the roof and demand of our president to resign is to dance into the tune of the enemy forces. We urge them to retract their statements and help mobilize our people for the decisive victory of the African National Congress in the coming elections. We expect them to join the volunteers of the masses of our people to ensure that we defend the gains of our national democratic revolution. Comrade Castrals and Maroon Spark must appreciate the fact that their seats on the Isitlalwane candidate list remain open. The ANC will never close that door for anybody who wants to move South Africa forward.